please subscribe and don't forget to press the bell icon to get notified whenever we upload a new video.
As we are counting down to the Republic Day parade at Rajpath in approximately 40 to 45 minutes from now, there is some breaking news that is coming in. We are now being told by way of sources that the BSF will not be offering the customary sweets to Pakistan they generally do, to Pakistani rangers that they generally do on Republic Day at the Wagah border. General Jaiswal, are you surprised? You're joining us live on this broadcast. Are you at all surprised given the sort of tensions we have seen between India and Pakistan, the sort of cross-border firing we've seen between India and Pakistan, the number of jawans that we have lost in these cross-border firings? Are you at all surprised that India has decided, the BSF at least has decided not to offer sweets to Pakistani rangers?
I'm not surprised. When they don't deserve it, why should we give it? When they don't respect us, why should we extend a hand of friendship? Yeah. Giving sweets is a gesture of extending a hand of friendship. Well, if these people are not respecting our nationalism, our status as a nation, they're causing casualties to our men, why should we give them sweets? They just need to be ignored.
If I just look at the statistics that have come to us, General Jaiswal, just, you know, I know it's a day to celebrate India's military might, our cultural might as well. But a quick question here, and I think it's our way to remember all those 8 men, jawans, who have lost their lives, not just in cross-border firing in Kashmir at either the IB or the LC, but also to left-wing extremism. 8 jawans killed since the beginning of January. It's been a particularly bloody start to the year. Are you anticipating a hot summer in the valley?
Well, we will calibrate it. It is in our hand. And I think our military planners are there. They are very competent. Whether we have to make it hot or stabilize it, our military planners are there. And the chief is very clear in his mind, and I'm sure he'll give directions. It's incorrect on my part to trudge on his path. But as I see, it is a norm that has now been adopted that should Pakistan dare to harm our soldiers or our civilians, we shall be giving them prohibitive response. There is no change in this philosophy. So if Pakistan ups the ante, well, we are going to be giving prohibitive response. If they behave responsible, well, the things are going to be calm. So it all depends how Pakistan behaves. These are certain incidents which do not give a polygraph for the whole year.
And sir, you know, as we speak about the BSF deciding not to offer sweets on India's 69th Republic Day to Pakistani rangers, it's also important for us to remember all those jawans, all those soldiers who've lost their lives in the line of duty. In fact, the nation's highest peacetime gallantry award, the Ashoka Chakra this year, is being awarded to Garud Commando Jyoti Prakash Nirala. He again, 31 years old, laid down his life after single-handedly shooting dead 3 terrorists during an encounter in Kashmir. In the gun battle that lasted almost 6 hours, 6 terrorists, including the nephew of Lashkar-e-Taiba chief and mastermind of the 2611 strikes, Zakir Rehman Lakhvi, they were killed. The operation was hailed as one of the biggest setbacks to the Lashkar-e-Taiba, as its entire leadership in North Kashmir was wiped off by the forces in one go. Corporal Nirala is the first ever Indian Air Force airman to get the Ashoka Chakra for a ground combat operation. His widow will be there today to receive the award. All this, of course, as India celebrates its 69th Republic Day, where it will showcase its military power. It is, of course, customary to host one leader of a foreign country as the chief guest of the Republic Day celebrations. But this year, in a first, the parade will see not one, but 10 chief guests, the leaders of all member countries of the Association of Southeast Asian Nations, that's the ASEAN nations, who are here for a summit. Another new addition to this year's parade will be 113 women from the BSF who will be roaring across Rajpath performing some breathtaking stunts on motorcycles. I'm quickly getting in our guests in the studio this evening. You all know her. She's been the voice of many a Republic Day parades. Thank you, Rini, very much for being with us. General Jaiswal, we've already introduced him to you. Tracy Pereira is joining us from the parade ground in Bengaluru. Chaitanya is in Mumbai. Maha Siddiqui is joining us from Akbar Road. And Delhi, in Delhi is Aritro Hazra. He's there from Mandi House, I believe. To you first, Rini. We've always seen one chief guest. I've never seen more than one.
We've had two one year.
But ten, never ten. This is unprecedented in
totally,
many ways.
Totally. And I think in many ways, this year's parade is a real scale up in terms of size, in terms of the number of tableaus and the number of unusual entries. You mentioned the 113 women on the BSF motorcycles. We even have a tableau from All India Radio, which is unprecedented. We've never had. We've had radio covering the event live, but we've never had a tableau from.
This is for Man Ki Baat.
For Man Ki Baat. So Prasar Bharati being represented. Even the stage that is constructed for these guests and the President and Prime Minister who are there and the Vice President who are there is going to be three times the size that is usual. So 100-foot stage with bulletproof glass and all the other paraphernalia that goes for security. Mm. So really, really different. Very different from the usual years.
And it's a scale up even in terms of the number of tableaus that we'll be seeing this
That's
year.
Right.
So possibly a longer parade at a time when we have been trying to condense it and make
yes,
it shorter.
Yes. So I think the last year was 35. Mm. This year is 38. Mm. So in scale, even in the number of say the aircraft that are there, or you know the school children who are there, a lot.
Usually, it's over in 90 minutes. That's usually the given time. That's what
a 5 kilometer stretch, 90 minutes right up to Rajpath, and then it goes on beyond to Red Fort. So clearly longer. Mm. This year is going to be. I don't know how they're going to do time management, but that's usually a very tough job. So
ten heads of state.
So imagine the convoys that come, because you'll have about 9 cars or 10 cars for each head of state, right? Because and so the precision with which they come, it's almost going to be like a flypast. You know, you have to be absolutely precise about how many cars come and at what speed they come down the Rajpath, and they alight and move on, and the next set of cars come.
And
on.
Usually, the difference is in seconds, not even in minutes.
Yes. Well, usually it is longer. Mm. So you have time between the Prime Minister, the President, who comes with the guest, who's going to be there for the Republic Day, and the Vice President. Mm. So they're staggered. But in this case, since you've got 10 who need to be getting on before the President or the Prime Minister arrives, you have to ensure that they fit in that space of, you know, the ceremony at Amar Jawan and the ceremony that starts at the saluting base.
The first pictures that will, let us just quickly tell our viewers, the first pictures that will be coming in, Rini, from the Amar Jawan Jyoti.
That's right.
That is where the Raksha Mantri, the three chiefs and the Prime Minister of India will lead India in paying homage to our martyrs. Post that, they all move towards the parade ground, towards Rajpath. So that's again a 5 or 7 minute journey. And
Less.
Well, if you're the Prime Minister, much less. for ordinary mortals.
And our Prime Minister is a Prime Minister in hurry, so he will get there before.
Yeah, well, I just hope it's a clear day. It looked foggy to me, and as I was driving to work, I was thinking, Lord, let the sun be up. At least we'll get clear pictures from Rajpath and from Amar Jawan Jyoti.
I'm not too sure about the visibility up there, but the visibility down below has improved. Mm. Up there for the flypast, we need to be really, really, you know, sure about the visibility, because they will not allow the flypast unless they have clear skies.
And has it happened in the past that if the skies have not been clear, the flypast has been called off?
Yes, it has, of course, because safety is first. Mm. You can't have the number of, you know, aircraft that you have, fighter aircraft that are going, you know, past, to have any sort of untoward incident.
I'm quickly going to go across to Maha Siddiqui, who is joining us from near the parade ground. Maha, securing 10 heads of states, there are 60,000 troops on the ground, boots on the ground, I believe, both Delhi police as well as paramilitary forces. This will be not just a logistical nightmare, this will be a security nightmare as well for the government of India.
Well, it has been for the last 2 days, in fact, Shreya, because even yesterday, the security in Delhi was stretched because every theatre and multiplex was supposed to be provided security because of the Padmavat controversy. When 10 leaders from across the ASEAN nations, the six spouses, over 150 media personnel from these 10 countries and officials visiting with the heads of state and government were all in Delhi. And all these leaders were spread across the city in various hotels. They were in various hotels. The venues were different yesterday. They started off with bilateral talks in Hyderabad House, then moved to Rashtrapati Bhavan for a retreat, and finally for the summit to Taj Palace, which is now called Taj Diplomatic Enclave. So you can understand the kind of security arrangements that were required yesterday. The security really being stretched there because of the Padmavat controversy, but everything went off smoothly. In fact, our sources said that they do not doubt the capability of the security to provide adequate to put adequate measures in place for visiting leaders. They also said that there was absolutely no concern that any of the delegations expressed because of the kind of violence that we saw in North India over the movie Padmavat. So that was the sense that we got. But of course, you know, this was a showcase event for India. The fact that 10 ASEAN leaders are here for the Republic Day parade, that yesterday there was a commemorative summit to celebrate 25 years of association between the ASEAN nations and India. And, you know, perhaps the government would have not wanted this kind of mayhem that was unleashed by Karni Sena just to put up a picture of what India really is rather than what was made over the last couple of, weeks by the Karni Sena.
Maha, I saw the film yesterday. I don't know what the Rajputs are complaining about. Frankly, these guys are terrorists. People who attack small children, who attack a school bus, are terrorists. What is surprising to people like me is that three chief ministers in whose states we have been seeing these protests, in Haryana, in Rajasthan and in Maharashtra, not a word from these chief ministers. But we are talking about brave children. One of the highlights of today's parade will be 18 brave children who have been awarded by the Prime Minister this year. Seven of them are girls. Orator Hazra, I believe, did manage to speak to some of them. Let's quickly listen in.
I'll first go to Samriddhi, who fought with a robber who came to her place, who came to her residence. And then in while doing that, she also got injured.
Suddenly, usne chaku nikal liya aur usne mere gardan pe rakha, and he told me do not shout and all. That time mujhe realize hua ki ye thief hai. Then maine us chaku ko mere left hand se pakad liya aur bahut chalana start kar diya. And hamare beech kafi fight hui. Then maine usko thoda sa dhakka mara.
Aapko injury bhi hui thi?
Yeah, mujhe injury ho gayi thi. Yeah.
Can you show her hand? I'll just ask my camera person to show the hand. So she held the knife with her hand, and she held the front part of the knife, and this is how she got injured. 16-year-old Pankaj Semwal, who fought with a tiger to save his mother. Now that's something which gave me goosebumps at least.
हम सभी भाई बहन मम्मी मम्मी के बगल में मैं सोता था तो जहाँ पे हम सोते थे तो वहाँ पे हम अक्सर डंडा पत्थर रखा करते हैं तो रात 1 बजे की बात है कि अचानक गुलदार जिसे बाघ बोलते हैं तो अचानक सीढ़ियों से चढ़ के हमारे बरामदे में आ गया तो हमारी लाइट ऑफ थी क्योंकि कीट पतंगे आती है तो लाइट ऑफ थी तो इस चक्कर में वो ऊपर चढ़ गया तो मम्मी को उसने खींच के उठा के फेंक रहा था खेत में तो मम्मी रो रही थी तो एकदम मेरी नींद उठ गई और मैंने मेरे हाथ में सबसे पहले डंडा लगा तो मैंने सबसे पहले डंडा ही उठाया और उसके सिर में 2 मारा.
But away from the celebrations, there are politics over the constitution on the day that we are celebrating it. Opposition parties will be holding a silent Samvidhan Bachao march against the Bharatiya Janata Party in Mumbai today. The march will be led by NCP Chief Sharad Pawar, Maharashtra Congress Chief Ashok Chavan, and former Maharashtra Chief Minister and Congress Leader Prithviraj Chavan. National Conference Leader and former Jammu and Kashmir Chief Minister Farooq Abdullah will also be attending this march along with several intellectuals, we are being told. The march is in response to Union Minister Anant Hegde's remarks, rather idiotic remarks, about changing the constitution and removing the word secular from it. Interestingly, the BJP's Tiranga rally in Mumbai will be clashing with the opposition's rally. in response to the opposition's Samvidhan Bachao rally in Mumbai, the BJP is, as we said, taking out its own Samvidhan Samman Tiranga Yatra, which will be led by Chief Minister Devendra Fadnavis. The rally is meant to honour the constitution and the tricolour. All BJP MPs, MLAs and ministers in the state cabinet from Mumbai will be participating in this rally, which will begin by paying homage to Baba Saheb Ambedkar. I'm going to Chaitanya, who's joining me live this morning from Mumbai. Chaitanya, there are at least two rallies on a day when security in any case is supremely high, on a day when the threat perception is high, when, you know, all at least the police forces there in Mumbai will be on high alert. They will have this additional headache of two political rallies to deal with. When are we expecting to see these rallies? I'm assuming after, once the parades are over.
Well, both these rallies are scheduled in the afternoon. First will be at 1 p.m. and the other at 2 p.m. So the first rally would be about the opposition, which has initiated this particular Samvidhan Bachao Yatra that they will start today. And this will be carried out in several parts of South Mumbai. Now, that is something which is quite prominent because that is also a place which is also very crucial and very important when we talk about security, because it is also the place where we have the Gateway of India, the Taj Hotel, all these places which were attacked in 26-11 attack in 2008. So all these places are in the same area, and that is where the Samvidhan Bachao Yatra will be carried out by the opposition. Now, all the political leaders, all the political leaders of the opposition, right from Sharad Pawar, who is the president of the NCP, along with that the former chief ministers of Maharashtra, Prithviraj Chauhan, Ashok Chauhan, then also Sushil Kumar Shinde, and then we also have leaders from like Sharad Yadav and also Farooq Abdullah, who will be participating in that particular rally. On the other hand, where I'm standing right now, that is Shivaji Park in Dadar. So right behind me is also the Chaitya Bhumi of Baba Saheb Ambedkar, from where the BJP will start its Tiranga Yatra. And even this particular place is completely cordoned off now, because also for the Republic Day parade, which also takes place here itself, where the governor of Maharashtra will flood the national flag. So these are some sensitive places, and now, as you rightly pointed out, yes, this is an additional headache not only to the administration but also to all these security agencies, just to see to it that no untoward incident takes place. Now, along with these two rallies, they also have to take care of the security arrangements at the various theatres where Padmavat has released yesterday, because even that is quite crucial, because we have seen some leaders of Karni Sena who tried to protest in Mumbai as well as Maharashtra, even they have been now taken into preventive custody by the police. But then there is a possibility that any sort of protest can take place, and that cannot be ruled out.
Sure.
So security has also been stepped up at the theatres as well for that.
Okay, Chaitanya, we'll leave it there for the moment. Thank you very much. The politicians certainly could have picked a better day for their political rallies. In approximately, Rini, I think 10 minutes from now, we'll start getting first visuals from the Amar Jawan Jyoti, possibly some from the Rajpath as well, if the skies are clear.
Yes.
So before we do that, a quick look at what's been happening in the world of sports. It's been an interesting day for India. India has hit back on day two of the third test against South Africa on the back of some pretty impressive bowling performances from Jasprit Bumrah. India started on a good note as they dismissed Dean Elgar early, but night watchman Kagiso Rabada hung on with Hashim Amla and averted a collapse. Lower order batsman Vermon Philander too hung on for his 35 runs as South Africa inched towards to a first innings lead. But India broke the stand and managed to take quick wickets to concede a slender lead of 7 runs. Bumrah led from the front as he registered an impressive figure of 5 for 54. KL Rahul and Murali Vijay later steered India towards safety and helped visitors stretch the lead to a crucial 42 runs when the day came to a close.
We don't work like that. On another day, maybe he'll get more wickets than us, but we want to contribute as a pack. We wanted to create pressure as a pack. And it was always a dream to play test cricket, and to get a first 5 wicket haul over here is always a great feeling.
Probably one of the most spiciest wickets that I've played on. There's been a couple over the last 1 or 2 years that have been quite difficult. In England, there was 1 or 2. But yeah, quite challenging as a batsman.